fly pretty like a girl, and he got five stories to tell. I see both sides like a Hey guys, welcome to an industry leader interview. This is a very exciting interview because I've actually got a global interview, my first ever global interview, which is very exciting, with Paris, our community manager out in India, and the guy who builds all communities. And that's why I can't wait for this interview, because it's going to be fascinating to just understand all the nitty-gritty parts of how to build a community. Because at the end of the day, every business needs to build a community, whether it's a product, a service, there's a community behind it. You have those avid fans, those customers, someone is loving your product or service. So having that knowledge of building a community is invaluable. So I cannot wait to pick Paris's brain. So first of all, welcome Paris to the interview. Thank you for joining us today.
Thank you for having me,
Seb. Thank you very much, Paris. And I am really excited to pick your brains today, because I'm going to learn a lot about communities that I've not learned before. So I look forward to learning this today. Before we jump into it, I want to learn a bit more about you though, so then we can understand why you've gone into this community role, because I'm guessing you're a very people's person. That would make a lot of sense, because community building is a lot of face to face. So tell me a bit about who Paris is. Who is Paris, and what's influenced you into this role today?
Hello everyone, this is Paris, and thank you, Scott. First of all, let me thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you for having me here. If I talk about the journey, or if I say who is Paris, so right now I have like sorted it out and I figured out, you know, realization has been done, and now I know that I'm more a community person. But earlier, when I had no idea that there could be someone called community manager or community person. I was just like this always, like, you know, like helping people, making them connect with each other, knowing more and more people, like, you know, when I was in college, I used to ping people over LinkedIn and, like, you know, just go out and meet them. And through that, I started knowing a lot of people around my locality. I have been part of, like, you know, campus ambassador programs of 5-6 different companies. So in my college, I have been running my college football club, so I was the captain there. So again, I was the lead of my college entrepreneurship cell. So a lot of things I've been doing, a lot of different activities I've been doing, which were people oriented. And in personal way as well, I'm more into, like, you know, knowing more and more people. So it's kind of my personal brand was always like, you know, people around me always know that I exist, and I always stay there for them to provide some value in any form. So this all was kind of a personality which I had actually, and that's why this role which came to me again and again after changing a lot of jobs, now I have stick to it and figured out that this is something which I do every day, every time, 24/7, and you can actually get money out of this also. Like, you know, people pay you just to make people stick together and, like, you know, tell them, like, you know, keeping them together and just providing the value, which I have been doing since, I guess, so it's been a long time I've been doing it. So I actually entered in this role in 2013 when I started a co-working space in my town, from where I've done my college. Yeah. So the co-working space that didn't flourish, like we were three people who started it, but the designation which I had was the community manager there, which I had not much idea. It was just like, you know, it sounds cool, so that's why I took it. So I thought, like, it will be something which is related to people, so I just take it. But slowly it grows, and then the last company where I was working actually find the real meaning of the community person and how it can actually impact businesses, and how my personality will gel up with this role. And then in the real scene, I figured out, okay, I have found my path now, this is the right place, this is the right designation, and now I have to grow this. So I'm here right now, and I'm not a part of it with any company, but I have been involved in at least 8 communities right now, like somehow building it or enabling it, taking care of their offline chapters or city chapters, or probably helping them with strategies. So mostly, I've started loving this, this is the concept of growing a brand through the community angle. And I believe, yes, as you said, that every business needs community. Mm. So that's so true. Anything can be, just like anything can be sold, if sales is there, then the community can also be there.
Mm.
So, yeah.
Absolutely. No, that's amazing. I can understand. I can see where you've been influenced now through going from running sports teams, societies through college, and then obviously growing that and understanding through co-working spaces. It's amazing to see that journey and how it's quite funny because you were naturally doing it, but you didn't realize it, and then you realized suddenly it was a role. That's quite funny how we can be influenced like that through our lives, and now it's actually coming to fruition to a role. It's amazing to see that. And I think that's what's so important, is that shows that you're truly passionate about that, and that is truly what you're supposed to be doing, because you've been doing it since years and years ago as a young teenager. So I think that's so great that you're now in that role.
Other than any community, any bigger community which I have created, there is one which I have created for myself.
Mm.
For my personal brand also, I have worked in this way. But anyone who interacts with me, if I talk my brand, anyone who interacts with me, I should provide a value to them.
Mm.
And I should always be responding, I should always be taking care of them and giving him the value too, so that when the right time comes, they will give the value back. And that's how it happens in the community. You have to be a giver. Mm. So I have been doing it, implementing all the rules, all the tips on me, on my own brand, by building my own community. And it's a pretty good example. I have been there in the ecosystem for past 1.5 year now, and I know a few people just because I have always tried to give them value back.
Yeah.
So
I think that's the beauty of building community, is that you're not just building it for the brand, but actually it naturally improves your personal brand and obviously gets you out there, and the amount of opportunities from that must be just untouchable, because there's just, you can get in touch with anyone with whatever you need. So I think that really, and that's a big selling point for me when I got involved with TV and doing communities for them. It was just another sort of game. I just loved building the communities, and the opportunities was just off the charts, and I absolutely love that, because I'm also very heavy on the personal brand aspect. So it really is exciting to see that. And so what would you say in your role now? I mean, you seem to just love everything about it, but I want to get both sides. What do you love most, and then what do you dislike in your role right now in community build? What do you love, and what's maybe harder, however you want to put it?
The thing which I love, so absolutely, whenever you interact with a new person, that is the best thing which I love, about being a community manager, because it makes you meet a lot of people on the ground. So, but again, I'll tell you, okay, so the scene of community management is not that great in India, okay, it's still coming, our ecosystem don't believe in communities that much. They do understand a bit, but still there is a lot to come in here where they will start putting so much in building communities.
Yeah.
So that is the major problem here. And so because of that, you have, being a community guy in any organization, everyone has to do some extra tasks which are not meant to be. If you have been hired as a community person, right?
Mm.
So the major thing which you will be doing is to put in your time in building it, creating the conversation, meeting the people, and doing things which will be valuable for the people, right? But because what happens here, probably the stakeholders, or they don't understand much about it, or probably they are not, it's not like, it's not the main vision of the brand.
Mm.
So the guy has to get involved in a lot of different things as well while building it. So that might be a little frustrating at times, when you have to do some extra tasks which you're not supposed to. That could be a little irritating, but the best part of this is, I think there are many best parts of this. It's not just meeting people, it's very dynamic, it's not boring at all, every day is new, every day you have to work on something different, and since you are building it, building a community is just like building a own company, right?
Mm.
It's again people oriented thing. So you have to think in all the different ways. Like you have to be the strategist, you have to be the implementer, the operations guy, the communicator, the storyteller. You have to be the shoulder also sometimes when they want to tell you something. You have to have fixed thing when they're gonna say the harsh words. So you have to be everything while learning a community. So I guess that's what is it's actually challenging every day.
Mm.
And if you don't have a challenging job, I guess you're not living it.
Absolutely. So, no, I completely agree.
So I guess these are the things. Yeah.
No, it's huge. It is like lots of little companies, like you said. You're opening my eyes to how much you have to manage. It's not just building the community, it's all the other little things that you don't see until you really get involved. And it's quite interesting. And now I'm getting involved with more, starting to see all that side of things. It is much interesting to understand how a community building works and sort of all the little parts to it. It is very fascinating. So it's interesting to see how you've got there, what's influenced you, and your love for it now. So obviously I'm going to start with the very basic question first, and then we'll dive more deep. And the very basic question that I think everyone asks is, what are your top three tips for building a community?
Okay, the top three, okay. So before even building it, if you're building it from the scratch, the first thing is that you should know why you're building it, right? The why should be very much clear, and you should know who will be the part of it. So, before doing anything in this process, you have to research a lot. Research before you start, I'd say. Okay, while building, research the platform where your audience is, research their interests, research what they love, what they don't love. If you can do that research a lot, by meeting people offline, if that is possible. Okay, so that comes the first point. You just have to know what they're looking for, how you can enter with you. Once you've done that, now I'm just telling you something. You have to start our community from the scratch. These things can work for that person, not for something where the community is already there. So I'm just telling you some tips where you have to start a community from the scratch. If it's from the scratch, first you have to do the research. Okay, do a lot of research, meet people. It's just like, you're going to create a product for them, right? So before you create a product, you have to talk to your people, right? That will that be a feasible product? Will you be really needing it? If you want, you can validate it by creating one or two small blogs, sharing with the people. So first thing is research. Second thing for them is the content is the main thing. And your content strategy should be kick-ass. Because what is a community? It's kind of a bond between, you and me, right now we're talking, so we also have a small community, like we two other few other TV members are there, right? So how about we don't have any valuable conversations between us? We will never talk. If we are not providing value, to each other, we will not talk that much, right? So it's all about creating the value, and how you create a value in community is can be done through content. It could be in any form, blog, podcast, videos, or any such Instagram, Snapchat, or probably emails. So that depends on you. But the major thing is, you have to create the content strategy before even just putting blogs, without any planning. And secondly, your blog should not be, SEO specific blog, to rank you over Google. Your blog should be valuable. It should have some better research by putting that knowledge in front of numbers. So first is research. About the people, then you create the content strategy and use that content strategy and create the right set of information, and through that information you create the conversations, right? The content will bring the conversations, which will engage people, make them come together, make them unite, and more they will talk, more they will interact, the better relation, better bonding will be there. It happens So one day, let's say you have met a stranger today, okay? So today we are, if we say hi, it will be there will be a very small bond right now. But if we keep on meeting regularly, okay, if we keep on doing conversations regularly for a month, the bond will be more stronger. Right? It's just like, it's a normal functionality. It's just like two human, it's a very, basic human behavior. So your community is just like that. expectations. To make them feel easy, okay, this place belongs to me and I belong to this place and these are my people. So that sense of community brings only when you have the content strategy that too very very classy, like, you know. So searching, then your content strategy, and then I say I'm more into offline community building. Okay. So I think my touch comes when there's an offline meetup. So I believe in the IR meetups. So I say if there's any possibility of doing a in real meetup, do that. Okay. Nothing can beat a personal touch. Nothing can beat the real touch when you can shake hands, give a hug, or probably talk in front of faces and laugh together. So that is the most important factor of any community. That's the reality. Okay, the truth about being together, the bond can be more stronger when we see each other. So anytime whenever you are building a community from the scratch, first you research about the people, second you research your content to create the best conversations and bring the sense of community, and third take your online community to offline and make people meet each other, and probably every friend for sure.
No, I think that's huge that you say that last one as well, when you say face-to-face, the offline aspect. I think now, because we have online, it's so easily available, it's so easy to get social media channels and everything, it's so easy to forget that there's a person behind that. And like, even when you build big followings and you speak to everyone, I think it's so easy to just see them as a number and not see them as a person. And finding ways, I think it might be a bit difficult for other brands, but I think if every brand can find a way, like you said, to just get face to face with it, even like a beauty brand, they can throw in events, can't they? Just finding ways to get face to face, I think you're absolutely right there. Is that personal touch, that human interaction, just nothing will ever beat that of human interaction, that coming together is huge. And I think a lot of time people do forget that, having just the online and internet so close to us. So I think that's a really key one to take away from that. So that's interesting to know that. So it's research, content, bringing everyone together, and obviously getting face to face. So it's interesting you went online to offline, as because I was going to say, with the online and offline, I know you said you'd rather have them offline, but how, when it comes to building on an online platform, which platform do you tend to use when it comes to online platform? Which platform would you tend to use? And then we'll go into the questions of how would you take that from online to offline.
Okay, so if you're talking about the platform right now, I suggest the thing comes is the research, which I said while building a community. So if you can research it, if you know that your audience, you know, whether they belong to Facebook or whether they belong to Instagram, Snapchat, or if I talk about the real tools, like, you know, like which tool they belong. So it could be like a lot of tools, it could be Brizio, it could be like, you know, iLogic or Slack or Telegram or Zendesk. They could be anywhere. But the major times people are not there, and then so you call them and, like, you know, build a community on a new tool. But these social media tools which were like Facebook, like Twitter, Telegram, Slack, people are using them a lot, okay? So most of the community which I have been building are, you know, other teams I talk about, they're mostly not global, they're mostly Indian communities. And I've found out that people are there on Facebook, okay? Yeah. And secondly, Facebook is putting so much into groups now. They started putting boards also on outside to promote groups, like, you know, that much they're putting. Even the Mark Zuckerberg, he has started saying that he's more of a community builder now than a developer. So, like, you know, they know that the groups are the power of, like, you know, that's why people are there. They are bored of their feeds. So the only reason people come to Facebook is to check out what's happening in the group, what's happening in the community. So I guess it's one great tool, okay, but it happens sometimes, like, you know, I have a community of product managers, okay, so our product managers are not that active on Facebook. Right. So for that we took them to the LinkedIn, which is not that great tool by building it, but again, these product managers, they are not that much into online content and all. So they are more into offline things. So for keeping this community, you know, it depends on the type of community, type of people you are interacting with. So these people, they love meeting a lot. So we do a lot of offline meetups here, and very less online connections. So online is there to do some small contests sometimes, okay, to post the jobs or to share the case studies, only those things, but not much conversations are happening in these places because they don't want to, you know, they don't feel like putting their time in that online thing. Then we figure out, like, we have asked them a lot. Probably in some time we are trying working on it, they will be more active on online. But we have seen that they lose interest very fast. So here we put more of the offline angle. Similarly, if I talk about some youngsters, okay, they might not be using Facebook like the way we have been using it. Okay. So they might be using Instagram or Snapchat. So you know, that is focusing on a young generation who is there on Instagram or Snapchat. See, what you can do is, because you can't do conversations over Instagram, you can just post the content and then, like, you know, probably reply to the comments. But you need a place to do the conversation. So what you can do is you can use the tool Instagram to post your content, to reach out to your audience, but then you can redirect to them to the Facebook group. Right? You need a place. Like, you know, by giving them the content, okay, tell them, guys, our new post is there. Why don't you, like, a new contest we have launched about this and that, and it's been happening on Facebook group, why don't you join it? So that's how they will come. You have to make them a habit of being there, you know. And then, when they come to the Facebook group, make sure that you are providing the valuable content. It should not be bullshit. As they will now listen to you, even they will follow you on Instagram as well. So you have to take care of the people, like, you know. You have to keep the expectations always on the top of other of your community members, and then only you can flourish. So again, I will say that it's not about the tools, basically. It's about, like, how you reach out to your audience. So your audience has to be hit by your content all the time. So hit them. I'll say create content, use the Facebook group for building it, and hit them through YouTube content, through Instagram content, through Medium by putting up the blogs. Call them through the Telegram channel if possible, Slack channel if possible. Mm. Like, you know, however you can keep them all together, just keep on giving the content the way they want.
Yeah.
The place they are happy with. So have your community managers for different platforms on online and do it for different platforms. But whatever they're happy with, just call them at one place and then ask them. Wherever they want to go, we will be happy to host you there, and we will be there on the platform, and you can engage with us through our content on that platform. So I guess, yeah, there'll be perfect approach rather than sticking to one platform while starting it up. Probably that could not be a right approach.
Okay, no, I like that. And I think the two main things I took from that was just basically researching into the community you're building to understand where they are. Oh. And another really interesting thing you said was building that habit. I thought that was very interesting, of that continuous content and them knowing when it's coming, what value they're getting, is building that habit. I think from doing social media myself, that can be quite difficult, because so many people, they'll do it continuously for a few months and then they miss it a few weeks, and it's just, and then they're always in this grind aspect of building a following, building a group. And I think that's where a lot of people fall when it comes to social media, and why a lot of people, there can be a lot of hate on social media sometimes, because you're just constantly in this grind. But I think what you said there is building that habit is such a key thing when it comes to building a community. It's such a key thing. And I mean, I guess you can't really put a time scale on it, but it's just whether you just keep on going, just understanding the, pointing out the value, I guess just using the analytics to understand if that's good value, and then just continuously doing that. But that's really key that you mentioned that there. So I was going to say, do you need a hybrid between both online and offline? But I guess if, like you said, your product managers, they just prefer offline. So I guess you have a little bit of online and just mainly offline with them. Or would you always have a hybrid, or do you just go with how the community likes it?
So for all of the community which I have been doing, they all are hybrid.
Okay.
So not yet have any community which is just online.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Yeah, I have one actually, but I'm again planning to take it offline, because if those people can be interested in creating conversation about, probably, you know, doing conversation over one topic in my online group, So same kind of an environment I can create on the offline space also, right? So it's not like I guess any brand can take their community offline. Any brand. It's not difficult. You know, if the conversation is happening, let's say they are there for any reason, right? How about I bring that same conversation and then call them at one place? Well, it could be possible that when I'm sitting in India and my community is from South Africa, but what if I make the South African people enable to do the meetup themselves? It's not supposed to be that I have to come go there and do it. Like, I'll make them enable. Like, you know, you give the power to the people. So see what's happening is that a community will flourish more, I feel, is that your customer now is not just a customer, he needs a role also. Okay, he's looking for a role. If he can get a role at your company, it could be anything. For the names only, he will do it. He'll be more than happy because he's already putting so much of time. Like, you know, by putting a comment, by putting likes to your group, like, you know, by adding members. So he's already interested in you. If we can, you know, a lot of tools are there through which you can figure out. If you can find out the most active members and ask them to start meetups, like, you know, giving them the face, make them the brand ambassadors. Ask them, give them the resources and ask them to start the community at their place, like, you know, do some meetups, they will love to. And once that angle will start, once that offline thing will start, like, you know, the people whom you will meet for once, like, you know, in real, I guess the impact will be more better than the impact which you will create through the offline content. It will always be up than the online content. So yes, so I'll say offline is a must. For me, it's been, it has worked like a miracle. Like, you know, people who are met to different communities, they are my friends, and even you don't know when they can be helpful or when you can be helpful. Like, I think the kind of work I have been doing in the communities for the past 7.5 years, it's been like that I have become the last moment go to look guy for people. If things are not working, in the end, they will call me and ask me, do you have this guy? Do you have anyone for this? So I have become like that because I have been into so many countries, like, you know, so much of different. You talk about tech, I have been associated with tech, like, I was the evangelist there, so I know most of the tech people. You talk about the marketing, you talk about film industry, you talk about travelers, you talk about any kind of motivational speakers, beat bosses, or musicians, or the guys. So I know most of them because I have been either a part of it or helping them to grow their community. So it has become like, you know, so that's what I'm talking about. And it might happen when actually I met all of the person. So that's why I have that thought. So yes, I'll always say yes, please get into offline community in real meters and it will actually bring the sense of community to your members. And it will definitely be very much helpful.
I think that's huge, yeah. I think you nailed it on the head when you said brand ambassadors. So for other brands who's trying to figure out, because obviously we building communities, TB, it's networks, meetups, we do events, but when you look at beauty or maybe look at other brands who might not necessarily do events, I think having that brand ambassador is a good example of how every brand can run events, because at the end of the day, if you have someone else shouting about your brand, that's a great thing. Doesn't matter what you are, doesn't matter if you're promoting to fit in windows, it doesn't really matter. If they're shouting about your brand, it's great, it's more promotion. So so I think that's great to have, to just build brand ambassadors around the globe, and that allow you to go global as well. I think that's a huge thing you mentioned there. Okay, interesting. So we've understand how you build communities and the hybrid between online and offline, sort of managing that. And that's what I want to go into is, they must be difficult, because how many communities do you run right now? How many communities are you built? Is it, what number of communities?
So it's been like now 4 months that I've left with one job which I was doing. So there I'm just doing one thing.
Okay.
Building the community for the brand. Okay. And but I left that just with the thought that I'll work on something which will help more brands to get into community building. So and due to the connections I started getting, you know, people those who wanted to start their communities or they are already associated with it. So they just involved me. So right now, I run a committee of community managers, okay, in India, because it's a joint venture, you can say, of all of the community people in India,
yeah,
to make an ecosystem aware that how important a brand community could be, and like, yeah, you know, it could be another growth hack which they can apply to their brand. So we all are together, we are very less, just 100 people or 110 people. It's like, you know, real community people who believe in the power of it. And then I run a product managers community with a friend, who's the product enthusiast, and I'm the community enabler.
Okay.
Then I'm part of a crypto traders group where I take care of the offline community. Then I'm part of a testers, because my background, I have worked with Cinture as a test engineer. So I work with them also. So I'm helping them to organize the, you know, testers community. You know, where we'll do a crowdsource app testing, mobile apps are getting tested. Then I'm part of, like, so there's a friend who's into Nifty trading, right? So he wanted to do some workshops. I gave him the angle of, like, you know, how do you start a community around it? You know, create content, create the community, give the value to the people, and then you do the workshop. So again, I'm helping him in building that, you know, building that strategy. Then I'm a part of an entrepreneur's community called Pushstart, which is here in India. So a friend is running it, so I take care of the offline community in Bangalore for that. So, and then I'm part of few small communities like Startup Grind. So Startup Grind, you must be knowing, like Google, right? So I'm actually in that group. So I've been recently added to the Tech in Asia community group. I've been added to the Startup Weekend community group. There's a startup summit happening, so I'm actually helping them in the outreach and all. And so, like, TV, I'm already associated with the budding entrepreneur. So it's been, like, you know, things. There's a friend who's starting a 3D animators community. So on the tool Blender. So I'm actually helping him in, like, you know, putting the community and helping him to start a community. So if I have a thousand fingers, it could be 10 right now.
It's like
my notebooks are always full, like, you know, I just keep on revising them, changing them, and the work is keep on piling up. It's like, so yeah, but the plan is to, like, you know, every community, every type of people I'm with, it gives me another type of learning, like, you know, plus experience you already, like, you know, which you love to have. But the learning which I'm getting from these places, actually, That is going to be the real learning when I approach a brand, I mean, like, as a company, and ask them, like, you know, I can help you in building your community. So this is all just part of the journey with like, you know, I'm leading to. And the main goal right now is to make our Indian ecosystem aware about the importance of community. So that's why I started the interviews, getting the existing community managers, and they are also happy, because I don't want to shout alone that people invest in communities, because they won't listen to me alone. But if I make 100 people
love
say the same thing, they will love it. They will definitely believe in it. So that's the plan. At least 100 people will create a million people in fact.
I love the vision. I know you will achieve what you want to achieve, because, I mean, we know how valuable building communities is. And my question was going to be, managing 10 communities, which is amazing, but how do you manage it? Like, how, because the biggest issue I have with building, and I only build a few communities with TV, we're growing, we're in 8 cities now, but really I'm managing Manchester and Leeds communities, and I'm helping with the other ones. But the thing I struggle with is the follow-ups, and saying, because you meet so many people at events, and obviously you have the connections, you know, oh yeah, I know an app designer, I know a web designer, you know all these people, but to then remember who it is, or even, like, how do you manage following up people and everything? Like,
so, even, you know, like, the way I save contacts whenever I meet a person, I save it with the whole thing, like, you know, whole scenario, like, if I met him on that event, and probably in that talk specifically, so whatever is convenient, so I save it with the location, with the type of person, type of community he belongs to, so it's always like that. So that I always remember people. Secondly, so managing if I talk, I'll not brag about it that I'm part of so many communities, but yeah, because I'm not running all of them alone,
yeah,
right? So there are other people. So my role is to either is to get some part of it done, or probably do the strategy for it. But yes, there is work. There is definitely work. I either work on the partnerships, or probably creating the content strategy, or probably connecting them to the right people. Okay, it's much more task. So my trailer board is totally full. My Evernote is full. So I've been putting sticky notes in all over the place in my house, like, you know, wherever I can see them, like even next to my bed or whatever. In my washroom also, I have a sticky note. So everywhere I'm just putting it, like I'm putting also, I have a sticky note there. So I just keep on looking, like, you know, my phone and the notepad is full. So that makes me, it's like, you know, it's another experience right now for me, like, you know, my brain is working much faster and it's more engaged than ever, like, you know, because I have to do a lot of things. At some time I feel, damn it, I just want to drop everything, like, put my social media off, my phone off, and I just move out. And then I feel work done, like, you know, if I even put that down. So it's I guess it's just core motivation which I feel right now, like, you know, because I feel I have a better dream to achieve, and probably I feel it's just the part of my journey. So that's why I'm like, you know, I'm just doing a lot of things, creating the content also. Like, you know, I've been in a day or like every day or every second day, I go out and like, you know, go to a meetup also. I haven't stopped doing meetups, or I'm going for interviews also, taking interviews. Even now also, I'm doing the house get together, calling people who are to my place. So, and you know, like you said, how you remember people? I mostly call all of them, whichever I feel they are good, to my house parties. And like, you know, once they have come to my house, like, you know, the connection is always good, and they will never leave you. Like, you know, I really could be, like, you know, I used to have a big house, like after some time, where I can just, like, you know, community, I can do house parties. And like, you know, once they are in your house, they know you. It's a very good hack, I'm telling you. Okay. Like, you know, it's a real good hack. Like, you know, first of all, you have to be a good host, which I feel being a people person or community person, I am, plus my friends, they are also good. So whenever a person comes, so he always feels special, and like, you know, we are able to do the conversation. And then the relationship becomes too strong. And then yeah, it continues for a longer period. Then you have online media to keep it updated, keep it going. So it's been tough or difficult. But it's quite interesting, and that's awesome.
I think you've just dropped the best answer to a question I've ever seen in an interview. To throw a house party. That is the greatest answer to any question I've ever done in an interview. You've just allowed everyone to throw a house party to build a community. I love that. I'm all in for that. I think that's brilliant. Absolutely brilliant.
Coming to India, I'll tell you.
Yeah.
And once you're there in my house, I'll make sure, like, you know, then the connection, the bond which we will create, it will never break. I'll make sure that. So that's what we do. But yeah. So
yeah, absolutely. Yeah. It's hugely fun. Yeah, it's building that human interaction again. Coming into your home, it's a lot more welcoming. You're bringing them into your personal life. I can completely understand that. That's really key, and I think that's great to take that away. And obviously the other ones are having notes and having obviously all the information in your phone. And I actually spoke to someone recently who actually, they take a selfie with everyone they meet, and they keep it to the contact so they remember. Because I had this issue recently. I went to a meetup and I looked someone, I knew who they were, but I didn't know what their name was. And then that's where I learned this trick there, because the guy told me that, well, that's what he does. He takes photos of them and then puts a name next to them. So that's a little trick. But definitely the house party is my favourite one. So I'll start implementing that one. Okay, sort of slowly finishing off is, I just, because obviously when you build a community, we've gone how you build a community, manage a community. But how do you make sure a community doesn't get stagnant? Because I feel like even if you built an amazing community, you've got an amazing online platform, you bring value every day, how does it, because obviously I guess it's a big part of the strategy that you will change through time, because people are going to get older, the industry is going to change. How do you not become stagnant? How do you keep people engaged and not do the same events, the same content? What's sort of the source there to keep people engaged?
So how about only, like, you know, the community is old now, so a lot. So if you alone will think about it, there will be just one brain working for the solution. But if you put your members like to like involve them also and ask them, guys, we are getting older, it's been like now we have been doing the same events, what more idea do you have? And I'm sure like, you know, the more feedback you will get, out of that you can actually get the right ideas. And like, you know, you can revise the community guidelines, you can revise the community culture, and then do it in a different way. So the members will only tell you because they have been with you, and if it's a a good community, they have the trust, they are loyal to you, they will definitely tell you what this should be done to keep the community alive, because they also want to be a part of it.
Yeah.
So it's not only, it's probably in the starting. So see, what is a good community according to you? For me, it's somewhere where you don't have to create the competition. The day the competition will start happening that by itself, it's the best community. Like you have, like when I get Stack Overflow, you don't know who started it. I don't know who started it.
Yeah.
You know, like, probably the guy putting questions now. People are doing it, and the community members are answering to it. So that comes, that is a real sense of community. So if any day you feel it's dying, so you have to ask your community, guys, it's been happening, like, you know, we have been low, what we should do? Involve them. Like, you know, give them this target that their thoughts will be implemented, and their thoughts will be given value. And I'm sure you will get the right answer. Like, you know, the solution to flourish your community again.
Absolutely, yeah. At the end of the day, it always comes back down to the members, because that's why you're building the community, your brand, it is for the members, for the customers, the clients. And yeah, I think that was quite nice what you said there, that when you've done all the groundwork and you've grown, it'll just start flourishing itself, and events will start happening and you won't even know who's running them. And that's the beauty of what you've then created, is it's just doing its own thing. And I think that's when a community really becomes a community, because it starts to be active on itself. Well, I've learned so much in this, Faris. I really have, and I'm sure the community have as well. Is there any last words of wisdom you want to leave anyone with, whether it's to do community building, start, any last words of wisdom in anything, entrepreneurship, it's up to you.
Okay, so wisdom. I'll just say, like, you know, the way I have been dealing my life and my things, I'll just share it with everyone, like, you know, probably with you. But I've been a giver, and I always believe in giving things, like, you know. So the plan is to keep yourself aligned with your dream, okay, whatever you're doing, okay, and it should be, like, you know, self-sustainable kind of a position. Like, you know, you don't have to ask anyone most of the times. And if you can do that, like, you know, if you can just keep on going to your dream, and, like, you know, keep on working for it, hustling for it, and you don't have to ask many people, but in between, if you can give the value to the people, that is the best thing. Keep on giving value and keep moving, and don't look back, or don't, like, you know, expect something back from them. So the thing here is that be a giver, and don't believe in taking it back. Just keep on giving. And I have seen, like, you know, and giving could be like any kind of value. Like, even be a good listener. That is also a value. Like, you know, people around you, they need someone who can listen to them. So be a good listener. Or maybe if they need sense of motivation, you just motivate them. Or you strategize with them. Or you give them something. Or whatever you can do. Where you don't have to ask anything from them. Just keep giving. Just keep giving all the time. Like, you know, and don't ask for anything in return. And I'm sure the day you will be stuck at some place, I'm sure those people will be there to help you out. I'm a firm believer of karma, you know. So, like, I've seen, like, you know, having a good heart and doing things in a positive way, it has always worked. You know, the first thing of this is, then you have to be sorted enough with yourself. Like, you know, if you are not sorted, then you can't do this all the time. But if you're sorted enough, then you can just, you know, keep on running to your goal, and in the between, you can just keep on giving to people. So give, and the best.
No, I love it. Absolutely. Just give. Don't go for the ask, just how can I help you, not how can you help me, and it'll just grow naturally. I love that, absolutely love that. I think that's a fantastic thing to finish on. And is there anything you want to talk about business wise, any sort of plugs, anything you want to promote at all that you're trying to push or anything?
So, currently to the audience, if they are running a brand or something, and you have seen, we are talking a lot about communities, and it's a proven strategy. It's been there since ages, even before you were born. Okay, so we have been a part of communities even you don't know also.
Yeah.
Okay, even beyond that, so we are part of human community, human race. So, but implement that community angle to your brand. Try thinking in that way. Okay. Like I have read it at a lot of places that marketing, that the role of chief marketer will go down and even become chief community officer in future. Probably because it will be more people oriented kind of a job, and every business runs with people, right? So it's better that you just impose your content on them. It's better you create it for them, like, you know, give them the value through your content, and like, you know, I'm sure they will love your product more than that. And the second thing is that your brand may die, but the people you have earned, they will never die. So they will always be there. So invest in people, and yeah, keep on building whatever you are.
Okay. Fantastic, absolutely. Thank you very much for this interview today, Paris. And I'll put all your social media handles and everything so you can reach out to Paris if you'd like, as he is the community expert and the global expert when it comes to communities. And I've just pictures by all that. This is why I love doing these interviews, is they don't just learn, I learn. So I just get this free consultation. So I'm so happy we've done this today. So thank you very much. It's been an absolute pleasure. Guys, I hope you enjoyed that. Thank you very much. I hope you enjoyed that one. That was our first global interview. How exciting was that? And I look forward to doing more. Please do subscribe to the channel at Scott Mears, my Twitter at Scott Mears _, my Facebook and Instagram at Scott Mears Entrepreneur. As always, guys, it was an absolute pleasure. Until next time, we'll see you then. Bye-bye.
Bye.